It's a sound hadith collected by Imam Bukhari. He says, أن رجلين من أصحاب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم خرج من عند النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في ليلة مظلمة ومعهما مثل المصباحين بين أيديهما فلما افترقا صار مع كل واحد منهما واحد حتى أتى أهله. أنس بن مالك رضي الله عنه narrated that two of the companions of Rasulullah, peace be upon him, left his home in a very dark night with something like lights in front of them. And when they separated, each of them had one light in front of him until they arrived home. And when you say that right now, you say, so what is the big deal? You know, that's a flashlight. Where is the karama? Where is the miracle to have a flashlight while walking in the dark? Everyone on their phones now, they have a flashlight built in their phones. No big deal. Even in their watches. So what is the big deal? The big deal is you're talking about 1450 years ago. They didn't have light, batteries, flashlights, electricity, or any sort of power. They only had the sun during the day and the moon during the night. Whenever it was not a full moon night or the beginning of the month, it was totally dark except with the stars to guide them the route. So the two companions were Abbad ibn Bishr and Usayd ibn Hudayr. And both of them were among the chieftains of Bani Abd al-Ashhal. Bani Abd al-Ashhal from Al-Aus, the tribe of Al-Aus. And their leader, I'm sure you remember, was Sa'd ibn Mu'az. May Allah be pleased with him. Both of them accepted Islam on the hands of the first ambassador who had been sent by Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in this ummah, Mus'ab ibn Umayr. May Allah be pleased with him. He stated that Abbad ibn Bishr accepted Islam earlier than Usayd ibn Hudayr. But in any case, all of them were beautiful people, very righteous people. They didn't show resentment to the da'wah. When they heard that Mus'ab ibn Umayr was hosted, Mus'ab ibn Umayr, you all know him, Muhajir from Mecca. The Prophet ﷺ sent him to Medina ahead of him a couple years before the migration in order to spread the da'wah there. And what does or what did Mus'ab ibn Umayr do? Normally, he would sit and recite Quran. People, Arab, they understood the message. So those who would love to hear him, they would sit and they enjoy, and then in the meeting, they take shahada. When the news reached Usayd ibn Hudayr and those chieftains of Al-Aus and Al-Khazraj likewise, they decided to kick him out. So when Usayd ibn Hudayr came and he gave him an ultimatum, he said, you want to stay in our town? You stay quiet and you preach what you're preaching, or you get out. So he said, أَوْ خَيْرٌ مِّن ذَلِكَ. What about if I give you a better offer? What better offer you have? He said, تَجْلِسُ فَتَسْمَعُ. If you want to sit down and listen to what I'm reciting, if you like it, you can take it. If you don't, then I will not bother you anymore. So he said, that sounds like a good deal. So he sat, and Mus'ab ibn Umayr started reciting Quran upon him. He took shahada innocently in the same sitting. So these two companions, Abbad ibn Bishr, and Abbad ibn Bishr has another karama where he was guarding the Muslim army one night while he's standing, and he was shot with arrows several times, and he didn't want to interrupt his prayer until he couldn't take it anymore. Then he collapsed. He was bleeding while he was praying. So these two companions were with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and when they were dismissed, perhaps after Isha, they're going home. It's pretty dark. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them a karama, a novel, where each one of them is walking with a cane, with a staff. So Usayd ibn Hudayr, his staff turned into a flashlight. And he was able to see for both of them the road. And when it was time to part from each other, each one of them is going to his house, then Abbad ibn Bishr's cane also turned into a flashlight, and it made it clear for him so that he can go home. This news was spread among the companions. And what is this called? Karamah. That's an indication that Abbad ibn Bishr and Usayd ibn Hudayr were among awliyaullah salihin. And by the way, all the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah was pleased with them. So all of them were awliyaullah salihin.